Welcome back to CAD/CAM design tutorial. Today we are going to draw this type of industrial C-type clamp. In this tutorial I will explain how to make this type of clamp to the basic command. I will explain in this tutorial how to use basic command and thread feature to make this type of C-clamp. All dimension are in mm in this clamp. Now our first part will be clamp rod. Now first of all select new part and OK. Now change centimeter to dimension, our dimension millimeter. Done. Now select the front plane and sketch. Done. Now select the line, midpoint line and for construction. Draw like this. Now select the line and draw one 2D sketch. Like this, our 2D sketch will be done. Now select smart dimension and give a dimension to this our 2D sketch. Now this will be 12.5 mm. This line dimension will be 30, this will be 30 mm. Now select this line to this center line, dimension will be 9 mm. Done. Now select this line dimension, this will be 110, sorry, this will be 140 mm. Now done. Now press escape and drag, escape and drag this line like this. Now drag this line also. Now give a dimension. Now this will be 3 mm. Now this will be 5 mm. Now our 2D sketch will be done. Now go to this feature, revolve. Now done. Now see our rough clamp rod will be done. Now select the right plane and sketch. Now the sketch will be normal. Now draw one more circle to extrude cut. Now first of all draw center line like this and delete this line and draw circle and give a dimension. This will be 15 and exit sketch. Now done. Now go to the feature and extrude cut. Now select direction, mid plane, and this dimension will be 30. Done. Done. Now see our extrude cut will be done. Now select fillet and select both side of our extrude cut, and this dimension will be 2 mm, and change this will be 1. Now done. Now go to fillet and select chamfer, unselect this edge, and this dimension will be 2 mm. Now select one more edge, this. Now done. Now, how to make a square thread in SolidWorks? Link in I button and go through and see the video. Link in I button, and in this I button I will also explain how to make a square thread in SolidWorks. Now see, in this surface I will make a square thread. Now first of all go to hole wizard and select this thread. Now first of all select our square thread. Now select this edge. Now okay. Now see, now pitch will be 1 mm. Now select this and edit this pitch. This will be 1 mm. Now done. See, this will be done. Now one another side, the square will be cutted inside. Now go to this revolution will be decrease. Now this revolution will be 135. Now change, this will be 137 or 138, something near about this value. Now this will be inside cutted. Now see, and this will be 137. Now this revolution will be one more time change. Now see, this will be this offset, start offset and end offset. Now this start offset will be selected. Now see, now this will be reverse direction. Now see, this dimension will be changed. This will be 5 mm. Now done. And some revolution will be changed. This will be 142 revolution. Now this will be 142. Now see, this will be perfect. Now see, this will be perfect. Now okay. Now see, our thread will be perfectly, square thread will be cut inside. Now see, now apply. Now first of all go to metal steel and apply different type of polished steel and apply different type of appearance. Different type of appearance and our object will be look like good. Look like this. Now see, now save it. Now select desktop and create a new folder, Cclamp. Open and save our part and rename it. This part will be part number 1, Clamp Rod. Clamp Rod. Now save it. Now done. Now exit. Now our second part will be main body. Now look like this. Now new part and okay, open a new part. Now change dimension. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सिलेक्ट फ्रंट प्लेन्स इंट्रो वन सेंटर लाइन टू द मिड पॉइंट. नाउ सम ऑफ द चेंज, डिलीट दिस लाइन, इंट्रो वन सिंपल लाइन लाइक दिस. Now done. Now draw one line and select to the midpoint and draw one 2D sketch line like this. Dimension given, give a letter. First of all, draw this type of 2D drawing. Now done. Go to the smart dimension and apply this dimension. This will be 30. This will be 15. This line and this line dimension will be 25. This line and this bottom line dimension will be 30. Now this line and this line dimension will be 120 and this line dimension will be 25. This will be also 25 and this line will be 40 mm. Now done. Now select this line dimension will be 50, this line 10, this line will be 50 and this center line to this line dimension will be 9 mm. Now our sketch will be fully defined and see all dimension. Our total height will be 190. Now apply fillet. Go to the fillet and select different corner or two lines like this, and this dimension will be 10 mm and done. Now see, now our sketch will be fully defined. See, now go to feature and extrude and select direction mid plane, and this thickness will be 10 mm respectively. Now see, our half body will be done. Now select this face sketch and normal and draw one circle on this face. Now select smart dimension and give dimension. This will be 40 mm. Now done, and go to feature. See, now this will be 45 mm, is right feature and extrude. Now this will be 10 mm height. Now see, now go to fillet and this edge and this edge and this dimension will be 2 mm. See, now done. Okay, see, now select this face sketch and normal this sketch. Now draw one more circle on this face like this, give a dimension to the circle. This will be 30. Okay, go to feature and extrude. This extrude in reverse direction. Now see, now first of all select the reverse direction and this dimension will be 40. Now see, this will be done. Okay. Now select this face sketch and this sketch will be normal. Now draw one circle and give a dimension to this circle. This will be 16 and exit sketch. Now go to feature and extrude cut and select up to next. Now done. Now thread. Now first of all select the chamfer. Now cancel. Now select the fillet. Select this edge. This dimension will be, this will be 5. Select this and this edge and done. Now select this face and sketch and normal. Now draw one 2D sketch like this. Now give a dimension to this our 2D sketch. Now see, this will be 20, this will be 5, this will be changed little bit, this will be 7, this will be also 7. Now same dimension, this will be 7 7. This will be 7. Now done. This will be 10. Now our sketch will be done. Now go to fillet and apply different corner. Now select this. Now done. This will be 10. Done. Now one more time fillet on this extra edges. Now see, this will be 2 mm. Change. Now see, done. Go to feature and extrude cut. Now this dimension will be 3 mm and draft angle will be 45 degree. Now see, draft angle. Now done. Object done. Now this cut extrude. One more time change. This dimension will be 5 mm. Now change all 7 mm dimension will be replaced to 5 mm. This will be 5. Now done. Exit sketch and so our preview. Now mirror it, this extrude cut in another side. Now select, go to, first of all go to mirror. Now select our this cut extrude. Now go to, this will be delete, and go to this part tree. Now select this cut extrude. Now see, this is fully selected. Now select plane, this will be front plane, about front plane. Now see, this will be done. Now see our object half done. Now make a fillet on this inside cylinder edge. Select this and select this edge. This dimension will be 2 mm. Now see, and this will be done, and make a square thread in this inside hole. Now first of all we make a thread. First method is hole wizard method, and second method is a subtract method. We apply second method. Now go to the first of all insert and select part. Now select our first part will be clamp rod, and insert like this. Now see, now apply different relation to our clamp rod. Now select first of all coincident relation to this edge, to this edge. Now see, this will be done. One more relation, concentric clamp rod outer surface and our body, this cylindrical outer surface. Now this will be done, and see, this will be done. Now go to, first of all go to this insert, edit insert and feature, and go to this combine. Now in this combine select subtract. Now select main body and select our subtract body. This, now this will be done. Okay. Now see, inside cylindrical our square thread be done properly. See, now our this part will be done, and apply couple of radius on this. Now select the fillet and apply different radius on this edges. Now apply radius on both side. Now select this side also, select this. Now done. Now see, our part will be done. Now go to appearance and apply different appearance on this our second part body. Now steel, and select polished steel. Now see the object preview. Now select different object, look like good. Now select gold and select this radius. Full radius will be gold material. Now see, this side also radius will be gold. Now one more time, extrude cut and see, apply this side mirror. Now see, both side are gold. Apply appearance, applied. Now select different type of painted. Now go to scroll down and select this paint. Now apply this red appearance to this our body. Now see, no object. Now this will be done. Now one more appearance on this face. Now this red will be white. We can easily see it. Now apply. Okay. Properly see, now done. Go to painted and aluminium powder coating this radius. Now select one more time and apply this radius. Now done. See the preview. Now our object will be done. Now save it. Now rename in this C-clamp folder. This will be part 2 body. Our part will be done. This should be done and exit sketch. Now see the our part 3 clamp rod base. Now first of all open new part and OK. See, go to front plane and sketch. Select a construction line, draw like this. Now first of all in this dimension and edit this sketch. Now see, now this dimension 10 mm. Now draw 1 2D sketch. Now our 2D sketch will be done. Now apply smart dimension. This line to this center dimension will be 3 mm and this height will be 5 mm. See, this will be 10. Now done and delete this dimension. This height will be 5. And this will be 5 mm. Now select this dimension will be 4. Change this will be 6 mm. Now done and this line dimension will be 12.5. see, this will be done. Now apply fillet on this line. Now this dimension will be 3 mm and this dimension will be 6.5, means this will be done, fully defined our drawing. Now done. Now apply this fillet on this edge and OK and select this edge. Done. See, now simply go through OK and go to feature and revolve boss base. Now see our clamp rod base are, see the preview. Now done. So our clamp rod base are complete. So the preview. Now apply different appearance on this. Now see, our part 3 clamp rod base are done. See the full preview. Now save our part 3 clamp rod base. This will be saved. Exit sketch. Draw our fourth part, clamp rod handle. See the preview. Now first of all, new part and OK, and select this millimeter dimension and draw the front plane and sketch to the midpoint and for construction, and draw like this. Now select the midpoint line one more time. Now give a dimension on this 2D sketch. Now select smart dimension. This dimension will be 120. This center line and this line dimension will be 10 mm. Now this will be 7.5 mm. This dimension will be 5 mm, and now this line dimension are 30. Then now this will be also 30, and this dimension will be 5 mm. This dimension are also 30, and done. Now auto sketch will be done. Now go to this OK and go to feature and revolve boss base and OK. Now see. Now first of all, select this face and sketch, select this face, sketch, and convert entity. This will be converted. Now go to feature and curve and select the helix and spiral. Now see, this will be already value are given. Now this value are 15 and this pitch value are 2 mm, and this degree of this thread starting, this degree will be 0 degree. Now done. Now go to this OK. Now select the normal and sketch, draw one polygon on this tree in this front plane. In this polygon are 3 edges. Draw polygon like this. Now give a dimension to this polygon. Select smart dimension. One. Now change this dimension. This dimension will be 0.2. Now one more time change. This dimension is the 0.3. Now done. See, our profile and curve already. Now go to done and go to feature. Now see, now first of all exit sketch and sketch profile, select sketch profile, and our sketch profile will be done. And now select helix and see, this is not proper cut it. And now go to option, align with face, and see, this is aligned. Okay, now see, our thread will be cut. Thread will be mirror. Mirror, now go to first of all mirror. Now this feature to mirror this thread and this revolution will be delete. Now our swept means feature to mirror, select this and this will be up to right plane. Now see, our thread will be done and select OK. Now our handle will be done and now apply different type of appearance. Now apply different type of appearance. Now save this part, part number 4, handle rod. Now see, our fourth part will be done. See the preview of our fourth part. Now go to exit sketch. Now see, our fifth part will be handle knob like this. Now first of all this part and OK. Now change dimension centimeter to millimeter. Now go to front plane and sketch. Now draw one center line like this. And delete this line. Now draw one 2D sketch on this center lines. Draw dimension, give a letter. Now go to smart dimension and apply dimension. This dimension will be 5 mm. Then this dimension will be 30. Now this line dimension will be 25 mm. This line and this line dimension will be 7.5 mm. This line and this dimension will be 5 mm. Now this dimension will be 10 mm. Now our sketch will be fully defined. See, now drag this center line like this. Now go to OK and one more 3-point arc. Now go to feature and revolve boss base. Select this axis to this revolve. Now see and done. Now our knob will be ready. Now go to this chamfer and select this chamfer inside edge. Now this dimension will be 1 mm. and done. Now see, now first of all go to make a thread on this inside edge, select this edge and convert. Now this will be converted. Now feature, go to this curve. Now select this curve and helix. Now select in this pitch and revolution, this pitch will be 2, revolution will be 15 and degree will be 90. Now done, to OK. Now go to this wireframe preview and normal. Now draw one sketch polygon on this front plane. Now this side will be 3, means triangle, and draw polygon like this and drag this polygon. Now give a smart time. Now go to smart dimension and delete this dimension. Now this point and this line make a coincident like this. Now smart dimension, this point to this will be 1, height will be 1, and this point to this point will be 0.20. Now done. See, our profile will be ready. Now select this length of thread will be automatically 1.5 and sketch will be defined. This will be 30.30. Now our sketch will be done. Now go to feature and now first of all exit sketch. Now go to swept cut. Now select sketch profile. Now our sketch will be selected. Now select path. Now see, our preview will be show. Now go to this realistic view and select, go to option and select this align with face. Now done. Now OK. Now see, our thread will be properly cutted. Now hide this and see, the preview of our thread will be properly cut. Now go to this chamfer and select chamfer. Now select this edge and this dimension will be 3 mm and done. Now apply appearance, different type of appearance, and this our part 5 knob. Now see, our part 5 will be done, part 5, and save it, handle knob. Now see the preview of our part 5. Now our next step will be make a this type of our final assembly. all parts are assembled in our C clamp. Now see the preview of our C clamp assembly. Now first of all, new assembly and okay. Now browse a part. Now select this browse and go to our main body and open. Now this will be our main body. Now go to insert more component, browse clamp rod like this. Now insert clamp rod base. Now insert one more component, part 3, this clamp rod base. Open and drag like this. Now go to mate and select concentric. First of all select this and this surface. Now this both will be concentric. Now done. Now go to coincident, this surface, and select this inside, select this inside surface. Now done. Now see, this will be both will be perfectly met. Now go to lock this clamp rod and this base. Now this will be lock. Now drag only like this. Now select this concentric, select this outer face of this clamp rod and this body round surface. This will be concentric. Now this will be only up and down motion are possible, not a drag left right. Now make a screw relation. Now first of all select this temporary axis. Now go to this mechanical mate and select this screw, and this will be 1, and select this body axis and select this clamp rod axis. Now this will be done. Now hide this temporary axis. Now see, this will be rotate only, not a drag up and down randomly. Now this will be rotate. Now this will be only rotate. Now see the preview of our screw mate, preview of our mechanical mate inside the screw relation. Now this will be perfectly screw relation are done. See the preview. Now this will be done, and insert component and insert browse handle rod. Handle rod open. Now done. Now go to mate, this outer surface and this inside surface. Now done. See, done. Now see, this will be rotated randomly. This handle rod not fixed inside the clamp rod, this extrude cut surface. Now lock this both side, inside and outside of this handle rod. See, now go to mate and select this lock relation and select this and done. Now see, this will be not randomly move, and done. Now see, this is not a randomly move handle rod, and this will be fixed in clamp rod. Now see the preview. Now insert handle knob, one more component. Now see the preview. Now this is insert the body. Now first of all go to this insert component, browse, and this last component handle knob, this will be done. Now go to mat, select this face and first of all delete this. Now first of all delete this extra object. Now delete it. Now mat, select mat and this temporary axis. Now select this axis and select this axis. Now this will be coincident and done. Now one more relation, select and this surface and this surface. Now this what will be done. Now first of all press Ctrl and drag this part, select this part, press Ctrl and drag this part like this. See, now go to mat, select this axis and select this axis. See, and in reverse mat. Okay. Now one more time select this, select coincident relation, select this edge and select done. Both are lock relation, select this and select this handle rod, done. Now one more time select this handle rod and select this knob and done. Now these are in lock relation. Now hide this temporary axis. Now okay, now see the preview. This will be rotated but inside the body. Now we apply limit, maximum clamp length and minimum clamp length. Go to mat, go to advanced mat and select this distance. This distance, so we will increase. First of all select this surface and this surface. Now dimension will be 1 cm. We will increase step by step this dimension. Easily understand, this will be 2, 3. Now this will be our maximum length. Now this will be, we make this will be 9 cm our maximum clamp length. Now select this, this will be 0, our minimum clamp length 0. Now done and okay. Now rotate this, maximum clamp length will be 9 cm and minimum clamp length will be 0 cm. So this will be not inside the body, throughout body, not clamp rod are go. Now see limit are working. Now see the upper limit, this will be 9 cm. Now see, this will be done. This will be not upper side, maximum 9 cm. And see the preview, our our C-type clamp are done, maximum clamp length will be 9 cm and minimum clamp of object length will be 0 cm. Now see the preview of our object. Now see the preview of our today C-clamp tutorial. See the final C-clamp assembly. This will be done our today C-clamp tutorial. Now like and share video and also subscribe for new tutorial and save this assembly. Now see, done. Now go to this one and this will be final assembly. Now done, C-clamp final assembly. Now this will be save it. Now see our